Hello, I'm Troy Harmon, Director of Research, and this is Nick Antonucci, our Research Analyst, and this is your Wall Street Week Ahead from Henssler Financial for the week of May 8th, 2017. Nick, before we get into the economic releases, which are back toward the end of the week, why don't we talk a little bit about the S&P 500 earnings season that's ongoing?
Sure, Troy. We're about 80% of the way through earnings season so far, with another 41 companies set to report in the week ahead. So far, we've seen companies growing sales by 8%, and they're growing earnings even more by about 14.5%. If you compare that to analyst expectations, on the sales front, they're relatively in line, about a 0.5% surprise. Earnings, on the other hand, are beating analyst expectations by almost 6%. So far, we're having a pretty good earnings season.
Yeah, it'll be good to have earnings catch up a little bit with the price we've seen in the market
sure.
lately. All right, so second half of the week on Thursday, we get PPI, Producer Price Index, for April. Expectation 2.3% year-over-year growth. Nick, let's hear a little about the details.
Yeah, also expecting a 0.3% increase month over month. That's much better than the 0.1% decrease that we saw in March. This is kind of a precursor to CPI. It tracks price changes in prices for producers, obviously, as you can hear in the name. Seen as a precursor to CPI, which is actually released the following day on Friday. We're expecting a 0.3% increase month over month, 2.4% increase year over year, Troy.
Yeah, CPI, Consumer Price Index.
Correct.
Right. This is prices related to what everybody pays at the store, right? A basket of goods.
Absolutely. And this is one reading that's closely watched by the Fed. However, they don't use CPI as their inflation indicator. They use the PCE, Personal Consumption Expenditures, which was released May 1st, which was down to 1.6%, which is the first sub 2% reading we've seen in some time. That 2% is the Fed's target.
Right.
So there's quite a divergence here between the Consumer Price Index and the PCE, our two really focused upon inflation readings.
Right, yeah. March was not as good. Saw declines in both PPI and CPI. We're back to a more normal, positive inflation cycle.
Hopefully.
We believe. Yeah, exactly. So then we have retail sales for April. Consensus 0.6% gain. It again was negative in our previous reading.
Yeah, and again, the data should improve in April. 0.6% is the expected increase for the month. This is a good gauge of consumer spending patterns, as the consumer is a very important part of the economy. Speaking of which, the University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Survey will be the final release for the week. It'll be released on Friday, and it's the May preliminary reading, which should come in around 97 for the expectation. That would be flat month over month,
right.
But still a pretty positive reading. We look at this because it's obviously a good gauge of the consumer, which makes up 2/3 of economic output. And the way the survey is conducted, it's a 5-question survey across 500 households. So hopefully we'll continue to get some improvement in consumer sentiment, drive that consumer spending.
Absolutely. One thing we've been seeing in when they poll a consumer lately is some of the political bias creeping into the numbers. It's something we'll watch going forward. But as of now, that's your Wall Street Week Ahead for the week of May 8th from Henssler Financial. Thank you.